On this edition of SUTV News, Fargo loses its biggest flood fighter.
A program on campus is giving back just in time for the holidays.
And in sports, the Bison get their first taste of the bubble.
This is SUTV News, and it starts now.
Welcome to SUTV News. I'm Adam Kempenick.
And I'm Brittany Hovland. Fargo Mayor Dennis Walaker has passed away. Walaker, who has been battling kidney cancer, was 73 years old.
He had just been released from the hospital late Tuesday afternoon, where he was taken after Thanksgiving for complications from chemotherapy. Walaker, who has been mayor since 2006, was re-elected to his third term this June. In his youth, Walaker attended NDSU for 2 years before joining the North Dakota Department of Transportation. In 1974, he joined the city of Fargo as a civil engineer. There, he worked through the floods of 1979, 1989, and 1997. He gained acclaim for his handling of that 1997 flood. As mayor, he refused to back down and evacuate during the record-setting flood of 2009. Not only will he be missed by the community as the tall, gruff flood fighter, but his kind and generous spirit will be missed as well. Those who know him know that he was more than just a man who saved Fargo.
Unfortunately, he lost the fight, but he's still in our hearts and he's still Denny.
He was a great friend. You know, I say he liked buffets as much as I did. That's one thing we really had in common. You know, he enjoyed food and he enjoyed people.
Walaker's funeral will be this Sunday, December 7th, at Reinecke Festival Concert Hall.
This upcoming Saturday, the Bison football team is facing Missouri Conference rival SDSU for a second time this year.
Joining us live in studio for a preview of this playoff game is sports director Joel Sipper. Joel?
Well, the winner of South Dakota State and Montana State would determine who would play NDSU in the next round. Both teams had to brave the elements as it was snowing heavily at kickoff. The Jackrabbits won in a shootout 47-40 over the Bobcats. Walter Payton Award finalist Zach Zenner had quite the day with a career-high 5 touchdowns.
More on the game between SDSU and NDSU later in sports.
Well, after celebrating its 10th anniversary downtown last spring, the Fargo Marathon is making its way back to the Fargo Dome. But the 2015 race may be a bit more of our campus. SUTV News Director Cassie Rolfing has more.
Just the amount of people on the bridge.
If you were in Fargo last spring, this probably is a familiar scene. Every spring since 2005, the city of Fargo hosts the biggest race to hit the FM area. That race was brought back to downtown in honor of the 10-year anniversary.
To move to downtown was designated as kind of a one-time thing. You know, maybe again in another 10 years, if we go back to, you know, 20-year anniversary, we'd take it downtown.
But this coming spring, the race is making its way back home to the Dome. And those planning say it'll ease the stress of getting ready for the event.
Definitely the Dome is much easier to coordinate for us. The infrastructure of the Dome and the parking lot and everything around it is really made for events of this size.
Logistics aside, how do the runners feel about this move back?
There are a lot of people that are happy we're going back to the Dome.
And with the marathon being so close to campus again, will NDSU students become more involved?
Since it'll be starting and ending at the Dome, a lot more NDSU students will see it happening and a lot more NDSU students will see it like being prepared beforehand. So I feel like the 5K and the 10K at least will increase a lot, if not the half marathon, the full marathon too.
And if all goes according to plan, there will at the very least be a lot of support from Bison Nation.
I think the students take a lot of pride in being Bison and I think they want to come out. Welcome, people from all 50 states and numerous countries to our community and make it a memorable experience for them.
No matter how it plays out, those involved still have their reasons for why they love this race.
The atmosphere, I feel like the spirit of Fargo and who Fargo is and what Fargo means to people.
Cassie Rolfing reporting, SUTV News.
Although the marathon isn't until the spring, you can register right now at fargomarathon.com/register.
The North Dakota University System is looking for its next chancellor. Interim Chancellor Dr. Larry C. Scogan will return to his job as president of Bismarck State College next summer. The new chancellor is expected to be hired and working by July 1st, 2015.
When we come back, a group on NDSU is trying to give back to those in need.
After this week's 7-day forecast.
It's a bird. It's a plane. No, it's the power of free checking with Kasasa. First Community Credit Union offers free ATMs, mobile banking, and are conveniently located right next to the campus of NDSU. We also offer Kasasa, which is a free checking account that pays you cash. Kasasa requires no minimum deposit to open, no monthly service fees, and don't forget the free ATMs. Discover the power of Kasasa at your local First Community Credit Union.
The NDSU bookstore has everything you need to show off your Bison pride. The bookstore can have you sporting green and gold wherever you go. It offers many different brands, sizes, styles, and selection so that you find exactly what you're looking for. Shop the NDSU bookstore and show your spirit today.
Welcome back. Making the transition to college isn't always easy for students.
That's why the NDSU Counseling Center has created a new group that meets every week for first-year students. The group's main goal is to create a place for students to talk about the issues they are having while getting used to college. These issues can include moving to Fargo, study habits, roommate concerns, and more. The group is still in its early development, but those involved are excited to make an impact.
This is a really tough thing to do to transition to NDSU, so having these struggles is totally a normal thing, and just kind of normalizing it for everybody. I hope that's what the students that come would be able to leave with.
The group meets every Thursday. I am in the Counseling Center in Ceres Hall and will continue into next semester. For those with questions, you can contact the group's facilitators, Lindsay or Jason, at 701-231-7671.
'Tis the season for giving and helping those in need. The Equity and Diversity Center is asking those in the NDSU community to do just that. A food pantry and winter coat drive is taking place on the third floor of the Equity and Diversity Center. The Equity and Diversity Center started this drive back in 2009 when they discovered that winter clothing and food were an area of need for some students. Every year, the center collects 50 to 100 winter coats and receives large boxes of non-perishable food items.
Educating our campus population, and that's our students as well as our faculty and staff, that we have students who are all over the range in terms of socioeconomic status, and that we have students who have a lot of really pressing financial needs, especially if they're parenting. So I think it's important to educate the campus community.
You can help by stopping by the Equity and Diversity Center, which is right on University Drive. There are also outside of the bookstore, Multicultural Center, Memorial Union, and in Berry Hall.
A Harry Potter creature has made its way into NDSU history. A new species of stink bug has been discovered by Professor David Ryder and doctoral student Eduardo Fondes. They named this new creature Thestral Incognitus after J.K. Rowling's large winged horse of the same name. According to the release from NDSU, the Thestral has bone-like ridges that resemble Rowling's Thestral skeletal body.
The NDSU Volunteer Network is giving back. It's another opportunity to help financially strapped families bring joy to their children this Christmas season. To participate, all NDSU students and staff have to do is pick an ornament off the tree, show it to volunteer staff, and purchase a gift or ornament from their child's basket. Each ornament contains the child's sex, age, clothing size, and top three toy wishes. The Giving Tree is located in the Student Activities Office in the Memorial Union. Last year, the tree was able to help around 40 families. Students have until December 11th to pick out an ornament and December 12th to bring the gifts unwrapped back to the Student Activities Office.
A special delivery for a four-year-old Colorado boy fascinated with UPS.
It's a story you won't want to miss. Straight ahead.
The NDSU bookstore has everything you need to show off your Bison pride. The bookstore can have you sporting green and gold wherever you go. It offers many different brands, sizes, styles, and selection so that you find exactly what you're looking for. Shop the NDSU bookstore and show your spirit today.
It's a bird. It's a plane. No, it's the power of free checking with Kasasa. First Community Credit Union offers free ATMs, mobile banking, and are conveniently located right next to the campus of NDSU. We also offer Kasasa, which is a free checking account that pays you cash. Kasasa requires no minimum deposit to open, no monthly service fees, and don't forget the free ATMs. Discover the power of Kasasa at your local First Community Credit Union.
SUTV News is a production of the Bison Information Network in conjunction with North Dakota State University's Department of Communication Broadcast Program. For more information, go to www.ndsubin.com.
Welcome back. Thin Mints, Samoas, and more can be on your doorstep with the click of a mouse.
Girl Scouts are adding the option of ordering their cookies online. Each Girl Scout will be given their own webpage to manage. Ordering will be by invitation only. The program will be in select cities this year, but will launch nationally next year.
Prince Harry shares a secret, a huge treat for Breaking Bad fans, and Frank Underwood returns. Andy Rose has these stories in today's Hollywood Minute.
Prince Harry is sharing a secret.
On today, World AIDS Day, my secret is, believe it or not, I get incredibly nervous before public speaking.
The 30-year-old took part in the hashtag Feel No Shame campaign by Sentebale, his charity. The campaign urges people to share their secret in support of children in the African nation of Lesotho who feel ashamed to say they have HIV. Harry, wearing a red ribbon, thanked people for participating. Here's a treat for fans of Breaking Bad.
I'm gonna park right here.
I don't think you wanna be doing that.
Oh yeah? What are you going to do?
That was a sneak peek of the highly anticipated Breaking Bad spin-off, Better Call Saul. Here you see Saul learning just what happens when you mess with Mike, even if he's just working as a parking attendant. Better Call Saul premieres February 8th on AMC. Now to another fan favorite, House of Cards fans, your favorite show will return February 27th. It will be the show's third season on Netflix. For Hollywood Minute, I'm Andy Rose.
A little boy in Colorado is on his way to fulfilling his dream of becoming a UPS driver, thanks to a special gift from the company. UPS gave him his very own miniature UPS truck. As Rana Navini tells us, the boy became fascinated with the company after developing a special relationship with the delivery driver.
4-year-old Carson Kite is so good at his job, he doesn't even need hands.
Where's our delivery?
At times, he's a bit forgetful.
Where is it?
But he makes up for it with speed, hand delivering every package.
Thank you, Mr. Carson.
We deliver muffins. We deliver cookies. And they just love the packages being delivered.
Rocking and song, ride along. Rocking and that did not sound good.
The story behind how Carson got his UPS truck.
I make deliveries to Carson probably 2 or 3 times a week.
Starts with Mr. Ernie.
When Carson was born, he couldn't drink milk.
I know how money first comes, delivering my special milk.
So they sent formula, which is why Mr. Ernie would deliver quite a few times to our house.
UPS made a video about Mr. Ernie and Carson's special friendship and delivered him his wish.
I can't see!
Carson knew nothing about it and did not know that Mr. Ernie would come or that there was a little truck inside that big truck.
Like light switches here.
Carson's truck is just like Mr. Ernie's.
No, smaller. Check.
Everything Carson check. Does on the job.
Check. Check. Check.
He learns.
Ooh, go to my hands are freezing.
From the guy in the brown truck.
He's just one of those guys that to me is very special and has become a very special role model in Carson's life.
Can't just deliver it, they have to sign. I know what I'm doing, special UPS guy.
Nowadays though, Carson's truck is the only one driving down the street.
I have a package for you.
Mr. Ernie during the summer was moved off of our route in our neighborhood.
You can't catch me.
All the more reason it's so important for Carson to make every delivery extra special.
The UPS video is part of a company promotion inviting people to share their wishes this holiday season. It's been dubbed Your Wish is Delivered. UPS says it will donate $1 to charity for each wish submitted with the hashtag #WishIsDelivered.
Could you ever see your professors doing anything else besides teaching?
For this Seek Sidewalk Stampede, we went out to discover what some of the professors at NDSU wanted to be when they were kids.
When you were a kid, what did you want to be when you grew up?
I wanted to be a number of things through the years, but I think what I mostly wanted to be was a writer. Especially, I wanted to be a journalist. I wanted to work for a newspaper.
Well, when I was a junior in high school, I had an excellent English teacher, and I decided at that time I would like to be an English teacher, and preferably a college English teacher. So that's what it turned out to be.
Well, the funny thing is I was really into chemistry, so I took a lot of chemistry classes, and so my first major I actually picked because I wanted to make a lot of money. So I knew I wanted to be like a chemical engineer, like ever since I started studying in class.
When you were growing up, what did you want to be?
A coach.
A coach?
Yep.
And then how did you decide on what you are now?
Well, to be able to coach, you had to teach. So I had to get a teaching degree so I could coach. So I ended up teaching. When I gave up coaching, I couldn't give up teaching because teaching is coaching, I guess.
The thing about me wanted to be a sportscaster. In fact, I was a big Kansas City Royals fan, Kansas City Chiefs are from Kansas City, and I just wanted to call the games, play-by-play. And in fact, I made it all the way to college doing that at BYU. Brigham Young University is where I attended. My undergraduate degree was in broadcast journalism, and I covered sports. College sports for Fox Sports after that, and that's always what I wanted to be before I decided not to be that.
What did you want to be when you were growing up?
When I was a child, I wanted to be a princess, and then as I grew up, I wanted to be a businesswoman in New York City.
Joining us now is sports director Joel Sipper.
I don't know about you guys, but when I was young, I wanted to be a Kenny Loggins impersonator when I grew up.
Well, thanks, Adam. Well, playoffs are a very dangerous time. Playoff teams can be in the danger zone as it's one and done. Let's see how NDSU prepares.
It's a bird. It's a plane. No, it's the power of free checking with Kasasa. First Community Credit Union offers free ATMs, mobile banking, and are conveniently located right next to the campus of NDSU. We also offer Kasasa, which is a free checking account that pays you cash. Kasasa requires no minimum deposit to open, no monthly service fees, and don't forget the free ATMs. Discover the power of Kasasa at your local First Community Credit Union.
The NDSU bookstore has everything you need to show off your Bison pride. The bookstore can have you sporting green and gold wherever you go. It offers many different brands, sizes, styles, and selection so that you find exactly what you're looking for. Shop the NDSU bookstore and show your spirit today.
Welcome back. NDSU is gearing up for another historic playoff run. The Bison drew a familiar point in the South Dakota State for its opening FCS playoff game. And although these two rivals know each other well, it's a whole new game come playoff time. NDSU faces SDSU's high-powered offense that put up 47 points and 526 total yards of offense against Montana State last week. Now that senior quarterback Austin Sumner is healthy, that adds a whole dimension to the Jackrabbits' offense.
They have the ability now to really run it and throw it, and so it's hard to just stack the box to stop Zenner because the wide receivers and Sumner are clicking so well.
I think we're going to have to be a little tighter than we played last game. You know, I think we played off a little bit at the corner position a little too much. You know, I think we can make plays and play a little better in the secondary.
They're going to come back, they're going to go through the tape, and they're a great team at the end of the day. You know, and it's exciting, but at the end of the day, you know, you got to see those boys again.
In effort to prepare for South Dakota State, the Bison got its first look inside the new sports bubble on Dakota Field. Although shielded from the outside, the Bison didn't completely get away from the outdoor elements. The bubble does not have the right equipment to heat the bubble properly yet. This $1 million project has been in the works since September. The bubble takes approximately 5 days to inflate, where its highest point reaches 70 feet and covers 87,400 square feet. NDSU Athletics will plan to have the bubble up November to April for other sports to use as well. The Bison men's basketball team got their first chance this year to play in Shields Arena, and now it's the women's turn. NDSU will take on longtime rival, the University of North Dakota, on Saturday. UND is red hot, riding a six-game win streak. This game will be broadcasted on statewide NBC North Dakota. On the men's side of the court, the Bison fell to Southern Mississippi 78-65 last night. Lawrence Alexander scored 23 points and tied a school record for most threes in a game with seven. Well, for our last broadcast, we wanted to end on a lighter note. So now SUTV Sports gives you the top five plays of the season from football this year. Coming in at number five, Carlton Littlejohn stops a fake kick, and look at him, he gets that small miracle, though the kicker actually got to run the ball. Coming in at number four, we have Christian Dudzik versus Montana. It was a close game here until Christian Dudzik interception ends it. Look at him climb the ladder and seal the deal for the Bison. Coming in at number three, we have Carlton Littlejohn again. It was a monster game for Littlejohn here against Weber State. He's going to pick up this fumble recovery and take it to the house for an easy scamper. Bison would go on to win this game. At number two, Carson Wentz, back to pass, and he's going to lob one up. And look at the catch by Erzendowski, and he dives to go get the ball. But coming in at number one, starting off the season, is John Crockett. How about this, as he jukes the defender so badly, and then he is off to the races. There is no one to catch him. This brought the Bison back into the game and said that we are back. Now let's get a call from Scotty Miller from KFGO.
breaking it is John Crockett to the right side. 40, 30, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, John Crockett. He takes it to the house. An 80-yard gain from scrimmage, and the Bison are right back in this one.
Thanks, Joel. As finals week approach, students may be studying harder and sleeping less, but doctors say this isn't necessarily a good idea.
More on that when we come back.
More than 400 million people use Facebook to stay connected with family, friends, and colleagues. In addition to the millions of others who use Twitter, LinkedIn, Pinterest, and Flickr for networking purposes. While Facebook and other social media sites are great tools to help you connect with friends and build networks, you should also be aware of the potential dangers associated with using these tools. So, let's talk tech.
First of all, always be mindful of what you and your friends are posting online. Nothing online is private, no matter what security settings a website may boast. Anything posted online stays online. So take time to consider what you and your friends are putting online before you post it. For example, do you want your potential employers or your current boss to see embarrassing pictures that your friends have posted? There's also the question of how much information should you disclose on a social media site. Posting too much personal information could lead to lost job opportunities, harassment, internet stalking, and identity theft. Don't publicize information that the public doesn't need to know. Finally, you should think about who you want to see those things you've posted online. By evaluating the appropriateness of the privacy settings on your social media site, it is recommended that you customize your settings such that only your close friends can see your personal information, such as your home address, email, and phone numbers. Ideally, this information should not even be online. Additionally, social media networks frequently update their security protocols, so be sure to review and update your security settings regularly. With these precautions, you will be well on your way to enjoying a safe and secure social networking experience.
Welcome back. The end is near for many college students, the end of the semester, that is. With dead and finals week approaching, many NDSU students are held up in the library, union, or wherever they can find some peace and quiet. With that last minute scramble to finish off strong, many aren't able to find time for enough sleep. According to the Mayo Clinic, the average adult needs at least 7 to 8 hours of sleep per night. According to the University of Georgia, college students can get an average of 6, and as many know, even less than that during dead weeks and finals week. What many students don't know, however, are the health effects that can come along with not getting enough sleep.
Things can be impacted by not getting enough sleep. I mean, certainly just how a person feels, what a person's mood is like, especially students, I mean, how well you're paying attention in class, how much you're retaining things that you're trying to learn.
Other health effects can include a weakened immune system. While not enough sleep can be a bad thing, there hasn't been a lot of evidence stating too much sleep is.
Well, thank you for watching this semester of SUTV News.
Be sure to pick up a copy of The Spectrum and check us out on Facebook and Twitter.
Also, check out our website at ndsubin.com for your chance to win some special prizes.
Have a great winter break and the rest of the year.